Good morning, and thank you all for coming to this important announcement. I would like to acknowledge all those in attendance at the Bridgeton community event. Thank you for your assistance and participation in today's event. Today's announcement is the culmination of years of hard work by a lot of people, and I think it's only appropriate to begin by recognizing their efforts. First, I'd like to thank our EPA site team that has poured countless hours of work into making this day a reality. A special thanks to Jim Guilford and this Region 7 team for all of their hard work. And I'd like to acknowledge the staff members from the Office of Land and Emergency Management, the Office of Enforcement and Compliance Assistance, and the Office of General Counsel who have been an invaluable part of this effort. Especially like to thank Senator Blunt and Congresswoman Wagner for being here today, but also for I'm grateful for your leadership and your attentiveness to Westlake. Without your support throughout the last few years on this, we would not be here where we are today. And I thank you both for coming, and thank you for your attention to the site. It's been very important. And I know the people and the community there appreciate everything that you both have done. Thank you also to the Congressional District staff members for joining our team in St. Louis, including those from the offices of Senator Blunt, Senator McCaskill, Congresswoman Wagner, and Congressman Clay. Thank you, Bridgeton Mayor Terry Briggs, for all of the support you've provided for our meetings in Bridgeton. I'd also like to thank our state partner, the Missouri Department of Natural Resources, and two of our many federal partners, Colonel Brian Sizemore of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers in St. Louis, Colonel Douglas Gooderson of the U.S. Army Corps in Kansas City, and I understand Carol Comer is here in the audience from the Missouri National. Hi, Carol. It's good to see you again. Finally, I'd like to recognize all the community leaders that have dedicated so much of their time and resources to the site. I don't have time to mention each of you, but I would like to give a special thank you to the Community Advisory Group Chair Harvey Ferdman and your team, to Kay Dry and the Missouri Coalition for the Environment, and Don Chapman and Karen Nickel, who founded Just Moms STL. Thank you all. We are gathered here today to announce and sign the amended record of decision for the Westlake Landfill Superfund site. This action reflects President Trump's commitment to return EPA to its core responsibilities: clean air, clean water, and clean land. For too long, Westlake has been a blight and a burden on the people of Missouri, specifically in the city of Bridgeton. And for too long, Washington has failed to meet its obligations. Under President Trump, that is changing. We've made a commitment to finalize a cleanup plan for Westlake Landfill, and we're delivering on that commitment. In February, EPA issued a proposed plan to amend the remedy to address the contamination at the Westville Lake Landfill. Today, we are finalizing that plan. This will end decades of uncertainty and pave the way to the remedial design phase. Once the design begins, it will take about a year and a half to complete, and once the design is complete, construction work for the remedy can begin. This decision is compliant with the law. It's based on sound science, and it considers the state's, and most importantly, the community's positions and concerns in accordance with the National Contingency Plan. The improvements we've made to the proposed plan will reduce exposure to the community and cleanup workers. It will speed up construction time by a year, and it will allow the flexibility to more efficiently remove the contamination from the landfill. And I want to emphasize that again, remove the contamination from the landfill. By focusing on areas with higher radioactivity, we're removing virtually the same amount of radioactivity as the preferred alternative in the proposed plan, while minimizing the amount of material that has to be handled. About 61,000 cubic yards less of the non-radioactive waste will have to be handled, to be specific. Thanks to those improvements, our final remedy will be completed a year sooner and for $30 million less. We believe this decision strikes the right balance and emphasizes the health and safety of the community. We have worked hard to regain the community's trust, and we will continue to prove that we are deserving of it. We will remain engaged with you throughout the entire process moving forward. Today's decision not only reflects our commitment to the people of Bridgeton and Missouri, but it also reflects our larger commitment to the nation to expedite the remediation of Superfund sites across the country. We owe it to the American people to get these sites cleaned up as quickly and as safely as possible, and we are making tremendous progress in that regard, in large part because of the many of the people in the room here today. Thank you all for joining us today, and I'm excited to sign this record of decision and see this effort through to the very end. It is now my privilege to introduce Senator Roy Blunt, Senator for the State of Missouri. Senator Blunt serves on the Appropriations Committee, the Commerce, Science, and Transportation Committee, Select Committee on Intelligence, and Senate Rules Committee. He is the Chairman of the Rules Committee and Chairman of the Appropriations Subcommittee on Labor, Health Services, and Education. As you can see, Senator Blunt is a very busy man, and we're grateful for your attendance here today.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Administrator Wheeler. Pleased to be here. This has been a frustrating challenge for all of us to deal with. All of the time I've been in the Congress, all of the time I've been in the Senate, we have been pushing to find a solution here. Senator McCaskill and I on the Senate side actually passed some legislation to take this away from EPA, who continue to miss deadline after deadline. But that was then and this is now. Congressman Clay and Congresswoman Wagner equally vigorous on the House side to continue to keep the fire burning here to get something done, to get rid of the fire that was burning. Carol Comer has been great to work with at DNR. Stephen Cook, as the regional director and the acting, has been great to try to find a solution. I do remember my first discussion with Administrator Pruitt. This was a top-of-the-line issue, and I also remember him saying, how could anything be a national priority for 28 years and not be done? And certainly my first discussion with Administrator Wheeler, this was a top-of-the-line issue, and fortunately he felt the same way. Projects of national concern, of national priority, need to be treated exactly like that, just as our friends from Bridgeton know they should have been treated like that, just as the moms group know they should have been treated like that. It's an important day. We're going to be continuing to work to do everything we can at the Senate level and the congressional level to do what we can to help, what we can do to continue to encourage, what we can do to continue to see that deadlines are met. You know, this is a legacy of Missourians stepping up to be part of a project that nobody quite understood what it was at the time, the Manhattan Project. A Missouri president then, the first president to decide that this was a project that the conclusion of which could be used to end World War II, but the remnants of that were still there. Nobody understanding the danger of how those things were dealt with. And so the patriotic work of Missourians has continued to be a challenge for other Missouri families in the 70 years that have followed. But to see this come to this conclusion, to see a project like this, Mr. Administrator, the decision not to store on site, but to remove all of the dangerous radioactive material, not to capsulize it there, but to move it somewhere else is something that I think our members of Congress feel good about, as well as hopefully the families that have been living with this issue for a long time and the community that's been living with this issue for a long time. And as I said, in addition to working with Senator McCaskill on this, certainly our colleagues on the other side of the building have been vigorous in their effort, and we will continue to be vigorous to do everything we can to help you meet the timeline that you've set out to get this started in about a year and get it completed in a short period of time after that. Maybe a 4.5 year total window is the window that we're going to be doing everything we can to continue to encourage. No one has been more vigorous, no one has been more committed to get this done than Congresswoman Wagner, and I'm glad to introduce her to come up and say a few things.
Wow, big day. For well over 25 years, our community has waited for a safe and permanent solution to the Westlake landfill. Years of delays, inaction, and and broken promises by previous administrations have given way to today's signing of this record of decision. I am grateful to the administrator and to this administration who has listened to our pleas and taken the steps to remediate the site and hold the responsible parties accountable. For me, there is nothing more important than the health and well-being of the families living near the landfill and its community. Thank you to Administrator Andrew Wheeler and his team at EPA for making the Westlake Landfill Superfund site a top priority and providing a path forward to clean up this blight. Since my very first day, I had been sworn in, and 40 minutes later, I received a call in Congress. About Westlake. We have worked with both sides of the aisle. I have worked with Congressman Clay and others to get this done. We have pounded our fists on tables. We have held hearings in frustration. We have demanded answers and accountability. And most importantly, we have never given up the fight. Just Moms, Dawn Chapman and Karen Nickel, the community advisory group, our local elected officials, and the strong people living around the landfill in the St. Louis area, this decision is truly a testament to your dedication and perseverance. Your tireless efforts brought the national and the local spotlight to this issue and made Westlake a top priority at the EPA. It is truly an honor to represent and be a part of a community that is so very, very strong and committed. I thank you, Administrator. I thank the DNR. I thank all of those who have come to the table to make this happen. Senator Blunt, myself, Senator McCaskill, and certainly Congressman Clay will make sure that we see this through. I thank you.
And now I'll sign the record of decision. If the senator and the congressman would come.
I'm waiting to see this.